fat problems when solution. This is not a promotion of Lakme or any consumer product. In this video, I'm going to tell you, there are lots of persons who wants to become an entrepreneur. If you really want to become an entrepreneur, this video is only for you, because in this video, I'm going to clear fat problems. Like, what is the difference between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship? Apart from this, why only few people are able to get that much success they really want in their life through entrepreneurship, while some can't? Apart from this, third question is entrepreneurship is a good career option for us? Third question is, what is the disadvantages of entrepreneurship or becoming an entrepreneur? And the last question, how can I become a good entrepreneur or entrepreneur who can achieve their desired goal in their life? I'm going to explain each and everything in this video, so stay tuned to the end, because at the end there is a secret you don't want to lose. I'm Prashant Bhar, business coach, entrepreneur and influencer marketing specialist. So let's start the video. First question is, what is the difference between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship? So deep down in regarding entrepreneurship or entrepreneur, you have to understand what is entrepreneur. So what is an entrepreneur? A person or a group of persons who establish an enterprise to create an innovative product or service which can solve out many problems in the market, because on a daily basis consumers are rapidly growing in their number. So obviously the problems facing by the consumers, by humans, are also increasing day by day. So understand this thing, if you are able to solve out any pain problem by your innovative product or service, because entrepreneur is just a person or a group of person who set up an enterprise, scaling a business from this one case to a large scale by solving a problem of the persons. Just understand what are the problems they are going through, and there are too much risk in to become an entrepreneur, because you are set up an enterprise, you have to manage a lot of persons, you have to lead them. Your unique idea must solve out the problems of the customers. Apart from this, you have to do marketing. A lot of things is going on in your journey, and when you have a wholesome idea about what you have to do in this journey, you have clear concept, you have clear planning regarding this journey, then you can succeed. So what is entrepreneurship? Entrepreneurship is just a process in which you put a lot of efforts, lot of actions to create your innovative product or service to help out some people, and you have to find out a path how you can provide your product or service to those persons who really want this. You have to do proper marketing regarding this, you have to grab the attention of your target audience, and after that you have to pitch out your product or service in that way. So understand what is the difference between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. I will clear all the questions, but apart from this, I want to continue from the end. Like, what is the disadvantage of becoming an entrepreneur of entrepreneurship? Because it's not just about getting a tag of entrepreneur to write down on your social media accounts that I'm a successful entrepreneur, I have luxurious life, luxurious car, luxurious house, etc. That's the outcome you will get after becoming a successful entrepreneur. But before that, you need to do a lot of things in this journey. Yes, a lot of things, because in this phase, you will face a lot of insecurities. You will go through from self-doubt. You will go through from financial crisis. You have too much risk on yourself. You have problems of financial problems, like you have to give salary to a lot of people. So initially, when you are not getting any customer, all the money is coming from your investors or from your pocket. So understand that thing. In the starting phase, you have to create a customer base which can help you to regenerate money along the journey. The main problem of becoming an entrepreneur in the starting, you will face these main problems. First of all, investment. After that, you have to lead a lot of people. You have a responsibility of many people in this journey. You have to give them proper salary. You have to provide them proper infrastructure where they can work, or you can work from home, but if you are making a huge enterprise, you have to set up an infrastructure. Apart from this, there are lots of insecurities, lots of challenges in this path. In the first 3 to 4 years of entrepreneurship, it feels like quitting, quitting, quitting. but you have to go through the process. You have to be persistent in this journey. Sometimes you can even try 500 times and it still feels I have to quit that thing. Why I am doing that thing? Sometimes I also feel that why I'm doing that thing. I'm not getting any results right now. Maybe I get massive results after 3 to 4 years, but I'm not getting any results right now. So in this path, the main thing I want to say, just clear your why. Why you are doing that thing? If your focus is clear that I have to go from here to there and anyhow, I want to achieve that thing. So your why is clear. And how you can do that thing, the path will be clear when you are persistent throughout the journey. And that's the first 3 to 4 years. Even you can try 500 times, the 501st time you feel like quitting. No one is supporting me. I don't have that much investments. I don't have that much team. A lot of challenges. But you have to be persistent in that phase. You have to believe on yourself. This phase broke the entrepreneur completely, because even their family is not supporting in that phase. Your friends against of you, your family, the persons who you love the most, the person you love the most are also against of you. Everyone is against you. You just have to trust on your gut that I can do this. I have unique idea. I can go through with my team. I can go through alone. Okay. And I can solve all the problems of the customers, for the audience or the humans. When you have that much trust on yourself, you can go through the process. What people think that I am persistent. I am doing things persistently over 3 to 4 years, but they are doing a single thing. If you are doing something and not getting results, maybe you have to improve your work ethics. Maybe you have to change that strategy, because when you are doing anything and you are getting that result, every time you do that thing, you will get that result only. So understand that sometimes you have to change the strategies, change the planning according to the journey. Because in the starting, you don't have idea how to handle that situation. But when you are persistent in that journey, you will get an idea how to be persistent in that phase. Okay. So sometimes you have to change the strategies. You have to trust on your gut. You have to lead your team, because you are also failure in this journey, your team will too. You have to give them support. You have to maintain a credibility with you and your team, so they can also persistent in that journey, because that's your idea. Let me give you a secret tip. Yes, secret tip. No one is willing to build up your business. Everyone wants their money. Everyone wants their security. Everyone wants luxurious life, but not with you or without you. So no one can take care of your business like you. It's your responsibility. Hire, fire, everything is just in your hand. You just know how to manage those persons. You have to understand how you can lead them to get that much work from in that place. Please understand, entrepreneurship is not easy. Entrepreneurship is hard. But if you want to achieve the thing that 80%, 90% people don't get, you have to give that work also. Like those 90 or 80% people are not willing to. You have to do that work. After this, we have to answer third question, last question, that how to become an entrepreneur? How I can become an entrepreneur? What do you have to do? You just have to pick a skill. First of all, find out your passion. Let me give you a secret how you can find out your passion. Let's suppose current day is your last day. Current day is your last day. So what you gonna do in the whole day? That's your passion. If you know what is your passion, find out your passion can be monetized or not. If yes, then go for it. If no, you have to find out another thing. You have to find out a particular skill set regarding your passion. Okay. And upgrade your skill set up to expert level. Because when you get expert in that thing, people will seek out for a solution from you, and through that you can use your unique ideas. You can create an innovative product or service to solve out their problems, right? So pick a skill, master it, and create a product or service around it, so you can help other people. Sometimes your idea may be too unique, but you have to go for practicality. Yes, you have to go for practicality because sometimes many ideas are not feasible. You have to understand the practical situations of the world. There are lots of things, your financial problems and a lot more. You have to understand, you have to be accountable on your efforts while you are pursuing that journey. You have to believe on your gut. Okay, and you have to understand that the consumers are growing rapidly. Our population is growing rapidly. So their problems are also growing rapidly. So find out their problems and try to solve out their problems by using your passion or skill set. After that, you can generate a tons of money. If you can help a person and you have a $5 product, what? How much you earn? $5. If you help 100 people, $500. If you can help 1 lakh people, $5 lakh. It depends on the problem that how much people, how much persons are facing that problem and how many people you can solve out these problems easily. So try to automate your business. Many people think that entrepreneurship is a good career, and I was like, do you have to think of it that it is a good career? Obviously it's a good career, obviously, but you have to understand that are you really willing to make such actions, make such efforts to achieve your desired goal? If yes, then entrepreneurship is for you, because in entrepreneurship you can learn a lot of things. Let's suppose you did a studies up to 18 years. After that you go for a degree, after that for master's, for PhD, and something 20 to 25 years you study for 20 to 25 years and still don't earn a single penny in that phase with your studies. But when you are pursuing entrepreneurship, after 4 to 5 years you can build a luxurious lifestyle. Let's suppose you did studies for 20 to 25 years, after that you get a job. What is the starting salary of a job? 20k to 50k, that's all. Really, but only 20k to 50k, that's all you get when you start working as a fresher in any job in any industry. Okay, can you fulfill your needs with these 20k to 50k? Can you live a luxurious lifestyle with this amount, 20k to 50k per month? Understand that phase. Rather than putting your all efforts up to 10 to 12 hours a day for your boss, you can put efforts 6 to 8 hours for yourself. And within 3 to 4 years, you will be a completely next level person. Your skill set will be to your skill set get improved, your personality get improved, and a lot of things. Even your bank account, yes. Understand that thing. You have to upgrade your skill set with time to achieve the things what 80 to 90% can't. Okay, what are some qualities which show that you can become an entrepreneur? First of all, entrepreneur is always excited. Yes, this is the number one quality every entrepreneur. They are too much excited for anything and they have a lot of energy. Yes, because many people can do 2 hour work and after that they think I need sleep, I need to sleep up to 2 to 3 hours. But you can, if you are an entrepreneur, you can work 10 to 16 hours a day and still don't get tired. So energy is one of the factor. After that, you have to be flexible. Flexibility is the second most important criteria of an entrepreneur. Third point is you love traveling. Yes, many entrepreneurs love traveling. There's a reason, because they get to know a lot of things. They get to know about different cultures, different places, and the most my favorite dialogue is, God give you 2 eyes to visit only a district, a city, or a state, or a country, or you can explore the whole world with these 2 eyes. Poor person also have 2 eyes, rich person also have 2 eyes, but the difference is their mindset and the life they are living. So try to explore the things. Entrepreneur loves traveling. Me too, I'm traveling freak. And the last important category is while building relationship with other people. Yes, they can start a conversation with a completely unknown person and still that unknown person can fall in love with that person, with that entrepreneur. Not just real love, just like they love talking to that entrepreneur. Because they master, when you're becoming an entrepreneur, three most important skills you must have. First of all, communication skills you have to improve, leadership skills, and the management skills. If you can master these three skills, you can easily live a good life as an entrepreneur. So focus on those skills and That's how you can become a good entrepreneur. And the last question, only few people can achieve their desired goal while working as an entrepreneur, while 80-90% can't, because the simplest answer I can give, they have trust issues, they have lack of patience. When you're working as an entrepreneur, you have be macro patient. Yes, things can't happen overnight. Success can't be achieved overnight. You have to put efforts up to years. Yes, really, yes. You can put efforts 3 to 4 years and still cannot make a single penny. But after 5 years, you will be a millionaire. Yes, that's the beauty of entrepreneurship. So you have need to be persistent over all challenges. You have so much patience in that journey, because you don't know when you can able to hit your goal within a day, within a month, within a year, within 10 years. You don't know the time. What you have to do, you just have to improve your work ethics, improve your skill set regularly. Okay, and the last thing I want to say, just when you are becoming an entrepreneur, your mindset must be well focused, and try to maintain a diary where you can accountable on your efforts, that how much effort you are making every day. So you can't say that I work as an entrepreneur up to 3 to 4 years, Panchu said me that after 3 to 4 years you will live a luxurious life, but you are not, because you are not accountable on your efforts. When you are accountable on your efforts, you understand that I'm making that mistake, I have to change that strategy, or I'm not doing that thing, maybe that thing can generate a lot of money for me and a lot of things. Understand that thing. I hope you get all the answers. What is the difference between entrepreneurship and how you can start your career as an entrepreneur, or what are the problems you will face and how you can tackle out those problems, and you will face a lot of objections in that journey too. I already uploaded many videos regarding objection handling. You can watch out in my entrepreneurship playlist. Apart from this, subscribe to my YouTube channel, tap on the bell icon so you can get my video first. And if you still have any query, you can comment down. I will personally give you answer, provide a solution regarding that problem. So don't worry about it. Just comment down what are the problem you are facing as an entrepreneur in your journey. Okay. And after this, you will face a common objection that I need to ask to my parents regarding that opportunity, whether I can start that or not. So watch out that video to handle this objection right now. Watch out.